Oh, yeah. there's things I would do for Jesus I wouldn't do for anybody else. That truth is probably what's built our marriage. And you and I have both done things for each other that ultimately are for the Lord. It's true in life, and it's true in ministry. There's no one like Jesus. Our sin was great, his love was greater. He's just unique. And, you know, talk about betting the farm, but at the end of the day, you get more of Jesus in your life, closer connection with him, more of him working in you, more of him working through you. That's better than anything. Worth everything. I want to take a minute to just share something with you related to that. I realized I forgot an announcement, so I'm going to do a quick detour to announcement and come back. If you're not familiar, the room out there in the fellowship area, along one wall, there's a whole wall of books. That's the library. You are free to go through there and borrow books. And we're not going to keep track of it all. We're not going to try and have a check-in, check-out. You're on your honor. If there are books there that you want, take them. If you want to donate books for other people to read, they're good, bring them. Put them in there. There's also a table, by the way, with all kinds of VHS tapes and cassette tapes. Those are from my library over the last 20 years. I never got rid of them. I realized I've been through them multiple times. They're great, but I'm not probably going to do them again. So those you can take and keep. For those of you who don't know what a cassette is, if you remember, they're great resources. So just be aware of that. The tapes, you're free to take and keep, share with other people. The books, borrow, bring them back, you know, donate whatever.
Yeah,
okay. All right, as long as you have a VHS, yeah, that's just how that went. Never mind. Other things on the internet. There's a couple of groups I feel like the Lord just wanted me to highlight and take time to pray for or speak to for a minute. You know, we always end our service just a time of prayer, praying for each other. And I'll have the ministry team come up in a second. But first, I had the impression during worship that there's a number of you who are, in one sense, like me. And I'll explain that in a second. But, you know, I feel like the Lord said, you know, every church has a target, if you will. It sounds right, because everybody's welcome. We want anybody who wants to come, everybody's welcome. I feel like the Lord said there's two particular groups of people that he wants to bring here. And so that I and we will be aware of and think about and praying for. One of those groups is young people. Now, young people, I don't just mean children. I mean young teens, 20s. I guess these days, young is still 30. I vaguely remember those years. You know, I'm past 55 now. I'm not the future of the church. I'm called to invest in the future of the church. And part of what God wants to do is bring young people and see them trained and equipped to operate in the power of the Spirit and have an intimate relationship with God and be leaders and impactors in the world for the next 20, 30, 40, 50 years. The second group he was going to bring here are the poor. Poor financially, poor spiritually, poor emotionally. People who are hurting and broken. And this is, God intends this body to be a safe place for people who are poor and hurting to come and receive the Lord's healing and provision and have lives put back together. People who are really beaten up by the world. And they've got a church at that. But those two particular, God wants to bring and fill this place with. But as I was thinking about that, I said, well, Lord, you know, I'm not either one of those. Not wealthy, but I'm not poor. You know, taxes do not get there. And as much as I like to think I'm young, my kids have told me many times that those days are past. Some of you are like me. I'd say you're past 50. You're past the halfway point. And I think the Lord has a particular invitation for you if you are in my generation by the secret path. Which is to, again, be willing to bet the farm. You know, it's harder to stay radical as you get older. It was easier when I was 20. I didn't have as much to lose, and I had all kinds of energy and idealism and vision. And now, you know, one of my delights in life is naps. It's like, this is a gift from God. I didn't think that way when I was 25. It's harder in some ways to stay radical as you get old, to stay on the edge, to keep living for God, to keep giving financially, to keep serving when you're tired, to keep taking risks when you've kind of been, oh, I've been doing this for 20, 30 years now. God, I've taken enough risks. And I think for some of you, the invitation is the Lord is saying, will you do it again? Will you put yourself out there again for my sake and my kingdom's sake? And for the sake of young people who you don't know, you might not even personally touch them, but they're going to be touching other people. Some of them may be the ones who are touching your kids and grandkids and great-grandkids. Will you put yourself out there again with that? I don't know what that will look like for any individual person. Might look like you become an evangelist again. Might look like you're just serving in the church in a way that's simple, but it opens up things for other people. It could be as simple as, you know what, I'm just going to welcome people at the door and make sure they feel welcome when they walk in. Maybe you end up leading a ministry you got on your heart. I don't know. But I do want to do this. First off, I would like, if you're willing, you don't have to, because I know this can be embarrassing if you've never done before and comfortable, but if you're in my generation, if you're 50 or over, would you stand up real quick? And you got to stay standing.
God, that's the hard part.
Right? All the young people are on vacation. But here's what I would like to do. Now you realize, you got to understand, the thing God gives us, he gives us to bless us with, but also as a trust to pass on. It's never just for us. So if you will, I would like to just close your eyes for a minute and hold out your hands to the Lord, because I just want to ask the Lord to put a blessing on this generation to be able to bless the next one. So Lord, I look out and I see some veterans who've been in the trenches for years, decades for some of us, serving you, doing what we could, whatever you put in front of us, taking risks, sharing our faith, encouraging the hurting, reaching out. Holy Spirit, I just ask that you would come and that you would fill each one of us, each one here standing, afresh. That you would give a fresh blessing, a fresh knowledge of your love. An encouragement to every heart and every bit of faith here to realize that, you know what? We're not done. We're not done. A chapter might have passed, but the book's not done. And there's more. So Holy Spirit, I just invite you to come and fill afresh, baptize afresh, Lord, whatever, however you do it, and enable us to pass on and be a blessing to the ones you're bringing around us. The ones in our own families, the ones who are here, and the ones who aren't here yet. So I thank you for each one of these people standing in their service to you and their love for you. And I ask that you would launch us and launch each of them into another season of service in your power and your direction. Amen. All right. Go ahead. Thank you. My pleasure. Say, now everybody else stand. But I am going to say that. So if you weren't part of the first group, you're part of the second, which means we're looking, God is calling you to reach your peers, your friends, your relatives, the people who might, they might be younger than you, might be the same age, I'd like you to stand up because I want to pray for you as well. And then I'll have the prayer team come up and we'll do personal prayer.